Next, we have poster 74, vascular endothelial growth factor receptor 2 expression on oral squamous cell cancer, an immunohistochemical assessment. The authors are Edrisinghe EASD, Anuradha M, Veerasekara MM, Rich A, De Silva H, Husseini M, De Silva K, Gunasinghe R, and Yasavardhana SG. Presenting author is Edrisinghe EAST.
Thank you. Today's my presentation is the vascular endothelial growth factor receptor 2. It's an immunohistochemical analysis. This is a part of an ongoing study. The vascular endothelial growth factor is an essential one of the essential growth factors in the tumor development. This growth factor is there in the normal physiological conditions as well as in the tumorous conditions as well. So in this study, we looked at whether how much this growth factor, the receptor on the tissue has elevated and what is the pattern of elevation. So we did we took the samples after confirming histopathologically from the Apeksha Hospital Maharagama, the 30 cancer tissues, the wax blocks. And we took three normal postmortem samples from the Kalu-Bovila Hospital, and we confirmed it whether it is normal or not histopathologically. And we did the processing and did the immunohistochemical staining. So in this study, we used a software called ImageJ, which is a free available software on the internet. So we downloaded it and we analyzed these images. We took the images from the microscope and we analyzed the images and took the average value from each and every sample. So we there are two aspects on this analysis. We looked at the chromogen percentage because we use a chromogen for the immunohistochemical staining, and as well as we looked at the optical density. So in this part, the chromogen percentage, we saw there is a elevation in the chromogen percentage in the cancer tissue compared to the control samples, but that elevation was not statistically significant. Right. Then we looked at the whether there's elevation in the males and the females. So the males had a elevation compared to the females. Again, we looked at the stage and the grade of the tumor, and we compared it. So there is an elevation when it is going to the higher the grade, higher the elevation of the chromogen percentage as well as the optical density, and lower the stage and the grade of the tumor, lower the chromogen percentage and the optical density. So we came for a conclusion, and our results were tallying with the other studies that they have done internationally. And so when we can use this vascular endothelial growth factor receptor 2 as a tumor marker, and we can predict it as a prognostic factor as well as for a identification and the therapeutic marker. Right, thank you.
Paper is now open for discussion.
What's the availability and the cost involved with the procedure for routine use for the patient?
That is the problem, madam. The chemicals are a little bit expensive. That is why we went for a smaller sample size. So for this 30 samples and the three controls, nearly cost around 5 lakhs for us, for the all the processing and the chemicals, the wastage and everything.
The specificity?
The specificity, madam, we checked it, but we actually didn't calculate the exact specificity for this test. But our elevations are somewhat tallying with the international studies, because when we compared with the studies that they have done internationally for the oral squamous cell cancers, there are studies which shows when the optical density and the chromogen percentage elevates with the cancer stage and the grade, but there are some studies with few numbers which shows the other way around when and there's no elevation. So there are two patterns in the literature. So in our study, our results tallied with one type of a pattern, but there are other studies, they have proven there's no elevation, there's no significant difference between the stage 1 and 2 and the stage 3 and 4. So likewise, there are differences in the controversies in the literature as well.
And is it more only for prognostic users, if you are going to?
Yeah, because this is a part of an ongoing study. So we did the real-time PCR as well as the ELISA. It also shows the same patients, the blood samples. So it also shows there's with the stage and the grade goes up, the elevations in the gene expression VEGF. We checked only the VEGF-A. So there are A, B, C, D likewise. So we checked only the A. So there is an elevation in the pattern. And the serum quantification also we did using ELISA. So it also shows that when we go from the well to moderate through to the poor differentiation cancers, the serum levels goes up. So we can still, we need huge samples and do a lot of research on this to conclude this as, okay, this is a best prognostic or a screening marker, but still it is tallying with the other international studies.
Thank you. Please give a round of applause.